Okay, we're going to test high voltage rectifiers used in microwave ovens. Common fail part. And you have to test them in a special way. Because if you were to just test using straight resistance, and this is a known good high voltage rectifier here, you're just going to read open in both directions. If you see the meter over there, and reverse your leads, you're going to read open in both directions. That's because the internal resistance inside these diodes is so high that it just can't overcome the PN junction in there. So you have to test these in a special way, and you're actually going to be testing it using a 9-volt battery on the volt scale, DC voltage. Right now, this is just, I'm not reading anything, but I'm going to set this up with a battery in series with one of my leads. It doesn't matter which one, doesn't matter how it's connected, because you're going to reverse it anyway. Just follow along. So it doesn't matter which lead I connect this to, doesn't matter which terminal of the battery I start with, because it's all going to be reversed. I'm going to do it one way, and then you have to reverse it to check the reverse bias junction of it. So what I'm going to do now is check the voltage. I'm actually going to be reading voltage through the diode if it will have any. It's a 9-volt battery. A good diode will drop a few volts, so I'm not going to read a full 9 volts through a good battery. In fact, a good battery here, I'm reading about 6.2 volts. And this is a good diode, rather. It's a known good high voltage rectifier, also called a diode. Now, if I reverse, either I can do it a couple ways. I can either put this, clip this over here, and then put my lead here, and I will read basically 0 millivolts, junk, basically zero. My meter's just not handling that well. The other way to do that, if you don't want to reverse your leads, is to reverse the leads on the battery. So I'm going to put the red is going to go over to the positive terminal, the green is going to go to the negative terminal. This electrically is the same thing as just reversing my leads on the diode. And once again, we get, for some reason, a little better reading. But we're down in the millivolt range. If you get a close in on that, you see we're in the millivolt range here. And so basically 0 volts. Okay, now, so we're going to do this. That's a known good diode. That's what a good diode should act like. This one is a bad diode. And we're going to show you how a bad diode acts when you do the same test with it. Okay, again, first thing you notice is that you're getting a full 9 volts. In other words, the PN junction in this diode is not dropping anything. That right off the bat tells you, oh, we got a problem. So even if we come along here and let's switch our leads on our battery, put the green on the positive, put the red on the negative, and then let's go back over here, watch the meter, get the same 9 volts. Different polarity, but the same 9 volts. So this is how a bad diode acts, and this is an easy way to test it in the field. All you need is a regular standard multimeter. Doesn't have to be anything fancy. This is a $50 meter, and a 9-volt battery. That's known, fully charged. And a couple jumper wires, and you're just running the battery in series with one of your leads. Again, doesn't matter which one. And you can easily and quickly and accurately test whether or not the high voltage rectifier in the microwave oven is good or bad. It's a common fail part, and if it's bad, easy to replace. Bada bing, bada boom.